सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति प्राणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्व वेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै ब्रह्मदेवमात्मवति प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणं प्रपद्ये शान्ति शान्तिः श्रीचिद्गणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सत्प्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्तु निर्मपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवान्नमत्तो शतामतिः There was one word which I had not identified there. Some word in the beginning there. First of all, where are you gone behind? Here there was a word. I explained this, but there I said that I don't know what this word means here. It is not makara. You cannot have makara there, so it's Indra Neela. So it is not makara. You can't even pronounce it as makara. It's not right. So it is Indra Neela. I'd explained with Neela. Indra Neela is a sapphire. So Neela is basically a dark color, generally translated as blue. So here Indra Neela is a sapphire blue. So the sky looks like sapphire blue, but it isn't. Generally sky does not look that dark blue also, but at times you have various shades. So that is a bhranti. So we had explained the bhranti there, bhavartha, but the exact word was not known there. Okay. So coming back to 419th avartha. Jnani ajnaniyo. Jnani Ajnanino Vairagya Vailakshana Pradarshanam. We know that Jnani and Ajnani both may have Vairagya, but there is a difference in their Vairagya. In the case of the Jnani, the Vairagya is not only with the Vishay Jnana, but it Mithyatva Nishchaya is also with the Vishaya itself. So not Vishay Jnana is Mithya, but Vishaya is Mithya, is known to the Jnani. Ajnani only thinks that this Jnana that I have about this Vishaya, that is Mithya, but the Vishaya really exists. So he does Dosha Darshana Ityadi in the Vishaya. So he is trying to take away the Shobhana Adhyasa. There was a question offline about Shobhana Adhyasa, as to what is the Shobhana Adhyasa. So Shobhana Adhyasa is having Shobhanam, having value, where it doesn't belong. So inherent whatever value is there in the Vishaya, we add more value to it, we see more Shobhana there, that is Shobhana Adhyasa. And Shobhana, Ashobhana also equally. So Shobhana Adhyasa is that Adhyasa whereby it leads to Raga, whereas Ashobhana is where it leads to Dvesha. Raga and Dvesha are inherent to the Antakkarana, inherent in the sense they are manifestations of vasana in particular antakkaranas, but they are not inherent values of the Vishaya itself. So that is Shobhana and Ashobhana Adhyasa. The Vairagya of the Ajnani is due to inquiring into the Shobhana Adhyasa. He trains the mind to not get drawn towards the Vishayas in the case of Raga. and opposite in the case of dislikes or dvesha. Whereas the jnani has no such possibility because the vishaya itself is mithya. He does not have possibility of raga dvesha or shobana ashobana adhyasa. He does not need to inquire into it because he has mithyatva nishya with the vishaya also. Yadyapi shastrena yuktya cha ajnani api vishaya mithya iti janati. So it is not that only the vishaya's jnana is mithya for an ajnani. He also knows that the vishaya is mithya. So far we have said that an ajnani does not know that the vishaya is mithya. Now what is being said is that ajnani api vishaya mithya iti janati. How? Shastrena yuktyacha. He uses shastra as leading to the conclusion that vishaya is mithya. So it is not aparoksha, it is paroksha jnana. And he uses yukti. He looks at what are the after effects of indulging in a vishaya. Thereby, mithyatva nishchaya is not really there. It is on a case by case basis that he has to be alert, not be negligent, and apply the learning from the shastra. Tathapi vishaya mithya iti aparoksha buddhir jnanina eva bhavati. This aparoksha buddhi of mithyatva unto this vishaya, mithyatva jnana of this vishaya is aparoksha only for a jnani. Whereas it is indirect knowledge for an ajnani. Natu shastra parichaya vataha api ajnaninah bhavati. So shastra parichaya vataha. Shastra says vishaya is mithya. Therefore an ajnani agrees that shastra says vishaya is mithya. I do not know how. I may have to inquire into it. But shastra says it. I have shraddha in the shastra. Therefore vishaya is mithya. Because mithyatva is the culmination of mithyatva understanding about the prapancha, vishayas, is such that while you are in the waking, you should feel that it is a dream. That is the mithyatva nishchaya really. Jnani's mithyatva nishchaya is so second nature to him that he does not have to think, and it is not mithyatva there, it is actually tuchyatva as the nishtha increases. There is tuchyatva buddhi in the prapancha. Because his sharira itself, indriyas themselves are not existent, separate from him. So they aren't there really. It is badha samana dikran. All these are badhita pratyas in the case of jnani. In the case of ajnani, he has to think regularly and apply the knowledge as much as possible, but there it is not aparoksha. He has to force himself to withdraw from indulgence. So there is a huge difference there. नतु शास्त्र परिचयवतः अपि अज्ञानिनः भवति तस्माद् अज्ञानिनः परोक्षया विषय मिथ्यात्व बुद्ध्या न अपरोक्षा विषय सत्यत्व बुद्धिर् निवर्तते. नाउ दिस विषय सत्यत्व इज देयर इन द सेम अधिकरण वेयर विषय मिथ्यात्व इज आल्सो देयर. सो विषय मिथ्यात्व ज्ञान एंड विषय सत्यत्व ज्ञान कैन नॉट कोएग्जिस्ट टुगेदर इफ बोथ आर अपरोक्ष. जस्ट लाइक द ज्ञान दैट वी सॉ अर्लियर, aparoksha jnana and aparoksha ajnana cannot stay together. Paroksha jnana and aparoksha jnana can be there in the same adhikarana. Here ajnani has aparoksha jnana of vishayas. So vishaya satyatva buddhi is aparoksha. He says, how can this cognizable world, this transactable world, how can what I interact with using my five sense organs be unreal? So there is aparoksha jnana through all the sense organs. Pratyaksha pramana is there, pratyaksha jnana, pratyaksha shabda, pratyaksha shabda sparsha rupa rasa gandha, all these are pratyaksha to the ajnani. Now there is a paroksha jnana of vishaya is mithya. So Vishaya is Mithya. This Paroksha Jnana of Vishaya Mithyatva and Aparoksha Jnana of Vishaya Satyatva are together, thereby Aparoksha Jnana cannot be taken away, meaning the Vishaya Satyatva which is Aparoksha, that cannot be countered by Vishaya Mithyatva Buddhi which is Paroksha. इत्थम अज्ञानिनः यदा विषये वैराग्यम् उत्पद्यते तदा परोक्षमिथ्यात्व बुद्धिरस्ति परन्तु परोक्षमिथ्यात्व बुद्ध्यपेक्षया प्रबला विषय सत्यत्व बुद्धिरस्ति प्रत्यक्ष ज्ञान जन्य विषय सत्यत्व बुद्धि इज स्ट्रॉंगर प्रबला देन द परोक्षमिथ्यात्व बुद्धि देयर बाय व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट बोथ कंटिन्यू टू बी देयर टुगेदर ही नीड्स लॉट ऑफ एफर्ट तस्माद् अज्ञानिनः परोक्षमिथ्यात्व बुद्धि वैराग्यस्य हेतुर् न भवति दैट विल नॉट लीड टू वैराग्य एट ऑल किंतु प्रबलया सत्यत्व बुद्ध्या विशेषु राग एव उत्पद्यते दिस राग द्वेष कंटिन्यूस टू बी देयर अनटू विषयास बिकॉज़ प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण इज देयर व्हिच इज अनेबल टू बी काउंटर्ड बाय परोक्ष ज्ञान ऑफ विषय मिथ्यात्व कदाचित वैराग्योदय तत्र विषय मिथ्यात्व बुद्धिर् न हेतु सो व्हाट इज द वैराग्य ड्यू टू वी हैव एग्रीड दैट अज्ञानी आल्सो हैज वैराग्य अनफॉर्चुनेटली हिज वैराग्य इज नॉट ड्यू टू दिस विषय मिथ्यात्व बुद्धि इज नॉट द हेतु इज नॉट ड्यू टू प्रॉपर इंक्वायरी विषय मिथ्यात्व बुद्धि इज परोक्ष नॉट अपरोक्ष देयरफॉर दैट इज नॉट द हेतु फॉर हिज वैराग्य किंतु तात्कालिकम विषय दोष ज्ञानमेव देयर इज अ तात्कालिक विषय दोष व्हिच बिकम्स द हेतु फॉर वैराग्य सो दिस दोष दृष्टि इज डेफिनेटली नीडेड इट इज टू ट्रेन द अंतकरण बट दैट इज नॉट वेयर वन शुड स्टॉप Otherwise, raga dvesha will continue, vasanas will anyway continue, so raga dveshas will continue, and thereby vairagya, whichever is born out of this dosha darshana, will be fickle, will be flickery. On the other hand, jnanavan hi sarva prapancham api mithyatvena aparokshataya janati. By the way, is the screen clear and is the sound clear? I'm having some fluctuation in electricity. And I see some people dropping off also. So I'm not sure whether the connection is stable. Okay. Thanks. Jnanavan hi sarva prapancham api mithyatvena aparokshataya janati. In the case of a jnani, the jnani knows the entire prapancha as mithya aparokshataya. It is an aparoksha jnana. Which is called as Anubhava Sakshatkara. So while living in this prapancha itself, as and when the jnana grows, becomes more and more sthira, nishtha becomes more and more, then the prapancha initially starts appearing as a dream, and then even if it appears, it is not separate from the adhisthana, which is the Jnani himself, his own Swarupa. So he does not have to inquire at each moment. His interaction is like a dream interaction and not like a dream interaction where a person is under the influence of the dream. So imagine that you are a dreamer but you know that it is a dream. So this is the Anubhava initially of the initial instance, the Jnani who has Sthirata. As and when he is interacting, he knows that none of this affects him because he is free. This is like a dream. Thereby, he is not bothered about any of these vishayas because they are mithya. And then tuchyatva buddhi is when the jnani is in samadhi. Be it Sahaja Samadhi, it need not be Nirvikalpaka Samadhi. So Nirvikalpaka Samadhi is a state where every Indriya is withdrawn. Antakarana has no vritti. You have seen this. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. Now this chitta vritti nirodha, when the eyes are open, then that is sahaja samadhi. So the state of the jnani of the highest order is that. Jnana is same, but the gradations are due to antakarana being less or more refined in the case of jnani. So jnanavan hi sarva prapanchami mithyatvena aparokshataya janati taya aparoksha mithyatva buddhya aparoksha satyatva buddhir duri kriyate. Now this aparoksha mithyatva buddhi and aparoksha satyatva buddhi cannot stay in the same locus. So in the adhikarana, either there will be aparoksha mithyatva buddhi or aparoksha satyatva buddhi regarding vishayas. So aparoksha mithyatva buddhi is going to replace the aparoksha satyatva buddhi. Then this vishaya is mithya, sakshat mithya to the jnani. Tasmad raga hetu bhuta vishaya satyatva buddhir jnani no nasti. Thereby raga is not there. Raga hetu bhuta vishaya satyatva buddhi isn't there at all. Because the vishayas are not satya, you cannot have raga towards something which isn't there. Vairagya hetu bhuta vishaya mithyatva buddhi revasti. This vishaya mithyatva buddhi continues to be there. Therefore, vairagya continues to be there, natu raga. So, vigataha ragaha yasmat or vigataha ragaha yasmat jnaninaha sa jnani vairagi. Viragaha, then viragasya bhavaha vairagyam. So he becomes vairagi. Viragi and he has vairagya. This is how we talk about the tasya bhava, shany pratyaya. Yadi jnanino vishaye satyatva buddhihi punar bhavet, tada punarapi ragod bhavena vairagyam duri bhavet. So in the case of jnani, yadi jnanina vishaya satyatva buddhi punar bhavet, if the satyatva buddhi regarding vishaya due to earlier samskaras comes up again, punarapi ragod bhavena vairagyam duri bhavet, then this raga would go away. The ragod bhavena vairagyam would go away. So vairagya goes away. However, satyatva buddhi cannot come back because mithyatva nishchaya is aparoksha. Kintu aparokshataya mithyayati nishchate arthe punarapi satyatva buddhir na jayate eva. If the satyatva buddhi comes, then raga comes up and then vairagya goes away. This is the normal course of vyavahara. However, in the case of ajnani it is possible. In the case of jnani it isn't possible because satyatva buddhi won't come up. Because the mithyatva nishchaya is not by inquiry only, it is aparokshataya. Now, yatha aparokshataya mithya iti jnate rajju sarpe satyatva buddhi punar no deti tatha. So, example is the rajju sarpa. If you see the rajju as rajju and you know that there is no sarpa, sarpa is not mithya really. The sarpa mithyatva nishchaya is when you inquire into it, initially it is a technical word mithya. What is it? Sadasadbhyam anirvachaniya. So in the sadhana avastha, meaning in the example, when someone tells you that it is rajju, not a sarpa. No, but I am seeing sarpa. You are seeing sarpa alright, but it isn't there. So there may be some discussion there. During that time, the fear is there. The fear cannot be resultant of something which isn't there. There cannot be jnana, sarpa jnana of something which isn't there. So we say there is aparoksha utpatta, there is a anirvachaniya utpatti of sarpa in rajju, rajju sthala. And there is anirvachaniya sarpa jnana also. Both are anirvachaniya, there is an utpatti of both. We agree there. So there it is mithya. Anirvachaniya taya mithya. Mithya sarpa vishayaha, mithya sarpa jnana. Anirvachaniya mithya sarpa vishaya, anirvachaniya mithya sarpa jnana. But as soon as he becomes a jnani of rajju, rajju jnani, then adhisthana rajju jnana being aparoksha, what happens? This sarpa is no longer mithya per. You cannot use that technical mithya word. You have to say mithya, which is rudi artha also, as false. It isn't there at all. Where did the sarpa go? It isn't there at all. It wasn't there even when the Ajnani was cognizing Rajju Ajnani. Now this Rajju Jnani is not cognizing and knows that it wasn't there at all. So that Mithya is completely false there. Tuchha. This is what Jnani status is in the exemplified where Aparokshataya Mithya iti Jnate. This Aparokshataya Mithya is not technical Mithya anymore now. He does not have to say Sadasadmiham Anirvachaniya Mithya. He can very well say that Mithyatvam Kim Tuchhatvam. Why? Because it isn't there at all. Sarpa isn't there at all. Similarly, in the case of Jnani, Tatha Jnaninah Punarapi Vishaye Satyatva Buddhirna Jayate. Can this person who has seen Rajju as Rajju say that no, it is Sarpa now? He cannot say Sarpa is real anymore. Similarly, Prapancha being seen as Mithya, known as Mithya through inquiry, not because Shastra says so, but now I am so sure that it is Manana Siddha. Then I cannot have Satyatva Buddhi in Prapancha at all. Ittham Jnanino Ragasya Utpatti Vairagyasya Nivrittischa Na Sambhavataha. Thereby, Raga Utpatti and Vairagya Nivritti are not possible in the case of Jnani. Tasma Jnanino Vairagyam Dridam Bhavati. It is firm Vairagya in the case of Jnani. It is not flickery like the Ajnani's Vairagya where Raga Udaya is possible, Vairagya Nivritti is possible because Vairagya is not real Vairagya, it is Tatkalika, momentary. Vishay dosha drishti janyam ajnaninah vairagyam tu kalena duri bhavet. So, mind you, vishay dosha drishti is a sadhana. As long as a person needs these tools, person is a sadhaka. Sadhya may not be there in the case of Brahmajnana because it is his own swarupa. However, the sadhaka ajnani will have flickery vairagya due to this dosha drishti because not always can he do dosha drishti analysis. The buddhi should get bandwidth when it is colored by raga unto the vishaya or dvesha in the flip side. So that is why the antakkarana is said to play four roles. Antakkarana or manaha, broadly called as manaha, because the mind is the functionary, the whatever the mind does, sankalpa vikalpa atmakam manaha, that sankalpa vikalpa atmakam manaha plays is a role of the same manaha or antakkarana. And major part being that we remain confused, therefore the antakkarana is called as manaha also, that is a major role it plays. The other roles are buddhi, which is also actually a major role. Unfortunately, buddhi does not get enough bandwidth in antakkarana. Most of the bandwidth is afterthought. We analyze what has gone back. Very rarely can we analyze the situation as and when it is taking place, as and when things unfold. As and when the prarabdha unfolds, we cannot have presence complete. Because the mind is so overwhelmed that buddhi cannot step in. So buddhi is the second role. The smriti fails us, chitta. Smriti fails us because had the smriti worked, all our after effects would have come to the forefront and then buddhi would have had a say as to how to win over this raga or dvesha. Unfortunately, that doesn't happen. That is the third role. Fourth role, the ahankara, which is always there. So it is not seen separately per se. The ahankara, when it is manifest, it is ego. Otherwise, the individuality is always there. Now, the antakkarana, which is completely colored with raga because it is in the manaha. So when it is playing the role of manas, that time the antakkarana is so clouded that the buddhi functionary cannot step in. Completely, the antakkarana is hijacked by the manaha. So, vishaya dosha drishti janyam ajnaninah vairagyam, when buddhi gets some step in time, at that moment when raga comes up, then a person can inquire raga or dvesha on the flip side. So visheha dosha drushti janyam ajnaninah vairagyam tu kalena duri bhavet. Over a period of time, one can work on raga, dvesha and then vairagya. What happens? Ajnaninah vairagyam tu kalena duri bhavet. At that moment you have won over, but you have to try it again. And again the buddhi cannot step in because antakkarana playing the role of manas is too powerful. Raga dveshas manifest in such a manner that the buddhi cannot step in. They cloud the, overshadow the buddhi. Thereby, kalena vairagyam duri bhavet. Vairagya goes away, it doesn't stay. तथा ही यस्मिन विषये दोष दृष्टिर जायते तस्मिन् एव विषये कालांतरे सम्यक्तो बुद्धिर् भवति. He is an example as to what happens when there is dosha drishti also. So you say, no, this is not good, this is not good. But then again one indulges in the same thing. An example is given. So it is not a very, I'll just go through it anyway. So yatha sarvesham purushanam पशुधर्मान्ते स्त्री विषये दोषदृष्टिर् जायते पुनश्च क्षणान्तरे तस्यां सम्यक्त्व बुद्धिर् अपि जायते तद्वत्. सो एनी इंटेलिजेंस, हियर द इंटेलिजेंस इज विद एन ऑपोजिट जेंडर, सो इट वर्क्स बोथ वेज. सो पशुधर्मान्ते आफ्टर मेलना, सो आफ्टर यू नो वन इंटेलिजेंस इन मेलन एक्टिविटी, आफ्टर दैट अनटू द अदर देयर इज दोष दृष्टि. So unto the other gender there is dosha drushti, but that is not going to last because one will be, and it is said as, you know, animals also indulge, humans also indulge in the same thing. Buddhi is what differentiates a human being from an animal. So this dosha drushti does not stay. Punascha kshanantare tasyam samyakto buddhirapi jayate. Otherwise there won't be couples. Couples are there because of attraction among themselves, and although there is dosha drushti at the end of indulgence, still there is also kshanantare samyakto buddhi. Tatha cha yada dosha drushtir duri bhavati tada vairagyam api duri bhavati. So he gives a very gross example to draw home the point that to drive home the point as to this vairagya of an ajnani is kshanika. It will go away unless aparoksha jnana takes place. What his point is that jnana is what is very important. Even if there is vairagya as a sadhana chaturte sampatti, viveka janya vairagya is what is expected, and viveka janya vairagya leading to shamadama will grow upon that vairagya also. Shamadama will grow on vairagya, vairagya will grow on shamadama, they will build upon each other. Then mumukshutvam will be stable, or mumukshutvam will be the only ichcha. Moksha will be the only ichcha in mumukshutvam. Moksha ichcha will be the only ichcha left. Then when jnana takes place, that jnana, which is aparoksha, alone can take away this raga dvesha and make vairagya sthira. Mithyatva buddhi should become aparoksha. So that is the hetu of this long discussion there. Because vairagya is something which people give away after getting some paroksha jnana or some aparoksha even, but not sthira. It is not manana siddha. So it makes you happy that, oh, I have understood the vishaya, I know what Shruti talks about, I have inquired into it, I am sure that Shruti is saying that I am Brahma, but can I stay there in that Ananda Swarupa Brahma and not seek Ananda elsewhere like earlier? So what we have been saying is that karma and upasana is not the sadhana for moksha, and we have looked at karma in this context as Vaidika karma. Many of us do not have Vaidika karma. We don't follow Vaidika karma even if we have. Unfortunately, in this era, not following Vaidika karma leading to moksha, we have to understand that. When we say that the Vaidika karma and upasana do not lead to moksha, laukika karma is bahuduram. Laukika karma cannot lead to moksha at all. Karma is a very broad term, but karma in the context of moksha shastra, whether it is Gita or Upanishad, it is almost always when not qualified, almost always vaidika karma. So when we are saying it is not going to lead to moksha, we say, why do I need karma upasana? I can continue with shravana manana nididhyasana. True. However, I should be dropping the buddhi of ananda in anything else. Because what is this moksha that we are talking about? It is ananda swarupa. When I say karma does not lead to moksha, or when Shastra says that karma does not lead to moksha, and including this grantha saying that karma does not lead to moksha, it means that the karma, any karma does not lead to ananda. So when I say I need to withdraw from those which are not really the means to moksha, it also means that I should withdraw from any karma with the hetu, with the buddhi, that it will lead to my ananda. This is the tatparya. So it's sadhana buddhi in moksha is sadhanatva buddhi in ananda. If I say that if I do something, anything, then I'll get some ananda out of it, that is erroneous thinking. That thinking should be dropped. Thereby mithyatva nishchaya should be so complete that one does not indulge in anything for sukha. Sukha rupa, not thinking that it is moksha. But sukha is the thinking there. Moksha may not be at the forefront when one says that I'll get moksha out of anything that one indulges in, but the thinking is I'll get ananda. And by saying that I'll get ananda in something, one has misunderstood that I'll get moksha with this, without thinking that it is moksha. Because ananda is moksha swarupa. So much thought has gone behind in this inquiry that we looked at. Therefore, vairagya is something which should not be dropped. We should always inquire into the level of vairagya that we have, even if jnana is there. Tasmad ajnana drudha vairagyam nasti itham jnana itham raga vairagye kramena ajnano jnaninascha lingatvena upte. Now these lingas are talked about as indicators of jnani and ajnani. Vairagya is what makes or breaks a jnani, because without that there won't be jnanotpatti. If jnanotpatti is there, it won't stay. Anyadapi ajnani jnaninoho chinnamuchyate. What other indicator is there? Yatha prasado upari gajadi murti rupam chinnamasti tatha bandha dhamani ajnaninaha antakkarane saksha rupa murtihi vartate. Moksha dhamani jnaninaha antakkarane sakshi rupa murtir vartate. Sakshinaha visheyabhuta prapancha saksha iti kathyate. Sakshirupa murtir malina, sakshirupa murti shuddha, tatra sakshirupa murtau asaktaha ragi, sakshirupa murtau asaktaha tyagi viragi cha. Chanchalam brahmarupam jagadyo nijaswarupamiti manyate, sa dukha swarupe kupe nibajyati, achanchalam brahmaiva nijaswarupam iti yaha manyate sa ananda swarupo bhavati. So I just want to go through this paragraph complete together. An example is given. Just like you have on the top of a palace or a temple, you have these murtis of elephants, etc. You see old palaces and temples, you see elephant statues on top of the dome. That becomes the chinna. So from a distance, if you look at the dome where you see an elephant, etc., it becomes an indicator of a palace or a temple. So you know the direction where to go if you didn't know the direction. So I can see it is nearby. So these are the indicators. Similarly, he says, bandha dhamani. So a comparison is given in the exemplified. Ajnanina antakarane saksha rupa murti vartate. So that saksha vishaya, witnessed. What is witnessed, what is cognized, all that is at the forefront. Entire journey is towards the sakshya, not the sakshi. One is always going outward. That is the idea here when sakshya is being mentioned. And what is sakshya? Sakshinaha vishayabhuta prapancha sakshya iti kathyate. So this prapancha, vishayabhuta prapancha is sakshya, which is the commitment of an ajnani. and that is the bandha dhama. This is what leads to the abode of bondage, which is not where one wants to go. One wants to free oneself from bondage. Therefore, one cannot keep Sakshya Rupa Murti in the front. Moksha Dhamani Jnanina Antakkarane Sakshi Rupa Murti Vartate. In the case of Jnani, in his Antakkarana, there is Sakshi. He is committed towards the witness, to the witness, through the witness. So when he looks at anything witness, he comes back to the witness. He is not committed to the witnessed, he is committed to the Sakshi witness, which is his own Swarupa. So Sakshya, if you withdraw from and land into the Sakshi, then Sakshya and Sakshi are only names. As long as Sakshya is there, Sakshi is there, can be called as Sakshi. Not Sakshi is there, meaning that when Sakshya goes away, Sakshi won't go away. The name Sakshi will drop. So where is the commitment? So Moksha Dhamani, in this abode, so Dhamma Iva Dhamma. So in this Dhameva Dhamma, Moksha, what is there? This Antakkarana, which is free. The Antakkarana, which is the abode of Moksha, as long as Jivan Mukta has Prarabdha, so long this Antakkarana itself is the Moksha Dhamma, and in that there is Murti, which is Sakshi. Not Sakshya. And what is Sakshya? This Sakshi is who? Who is the witness there? Sakshi Murta, Sakshi Rupa Murti Shuddha, Sakshi Rupa Murti Malina. So the Tamas is going to taint. Tamas and Rajas also is going to taint the Sakshya, whereas Sakshi is Shuddha Sattva Rupa. Tatra Sakshi Rupa Murtau Asakta Ragi. One who is attached to the Vishayas is a Ragi, whereas one who is Tyagi and one who is not asakta, one who is not attached to the, even the Sakshi Rupa Murto Asaktaha, thereby not attached to Sakshya, who is free from, unattached from Sakshya Vishaya Prapancha and attached to the Sakshi witness. The Sakshi of the Sakala Prapancha is a Tyagi and Viragi. Chanchalam Brahmarupam Jagadyaha Nijaswarupam Iti Manyate. One who considers Prapancha as real, sa Dukkha Swarupe Kupe Nimajyati. He falls into this well of Dukkha. Achanchalam Brahma Eva Nijaswarupam. One who knows one's own Swarupa is Nija, Prapancha is not Nija, and this Swarupa is Achanchala Brahma, saha Ananda Swarupo Bhavati. So he becomes Ananda Swarupa, meaning he knows that he is Ananda Swarupa. He does not seek after, hanker after any other Ananda. Now we have landed into the technical part of Mahavakya Artha Jnanam, which was begun and the Siddhanta was mentioned. Now details are going to be looked at as per other Darshanikas as to what is this Jnana and Siddhanta also. Anyway, there is a Tippana. अज्ञानो दृढ़वैराग्यम न भवति इति अयम् अभिप्रायः भगवता भगवद्गीतायां विषया विनिवर्तन्ते निराहारस्य देहिनः रसवर्ज रसोप्यस्य परम दृष्ट्वा निवर्तते इत्युक्तम्. इन द सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ गीता भगवान कृष्ण सेज विषया विनिवर्तन्ते रिगार्डिंग दिस दृढ़वैराग्य वर्सेस द फ्लिकरी वैराग्य. ही सेज विषया विनिवर्तन्ते, द प्रपंच विषयास go away. One cannot indulge anymore. When one is not having food, so you start doing upavasa. Let's say Shivaratri, Ekadashi upavasas, Nirjala upavasa you do, the sense organs are going to be weakened. Antakkarana is weak, the buddhi is weak, you cannot talk a lot, you cannot think a lot, you cannot do a lot. So indriyas, karmendriyas are weak, jnanendriyas become weak. Of course, those who are trained, who have been doing upvasa across years, they don't have this problem. But it is not one ekadashi. We are talking about one who shuns food. One who says that I'll not eat a lot of food, I'll survive somehow. Why? To weaken the sense organs. One is unable to control the sense organs, so you weaken them. If the sense organs are weak, they will not draw me outward and I can remain in dhyana ityadi. There are these yogic methods which are there. You star yourselves. If you star yourself, then also vishayas go away. Because, you know, poetically it is said that he is not giving me any value. So if you personify vishayas, they are going to go away. So just like, you know, somebody expects attention, you are not giving attention, the person will go away. Similarly, vishaya vinivartante niraharasi dehinaha. But how? Rasavarjam. Rasavarjam is adverbial to kriya visheshana to vinivartante. Vishaya rasavarjam vinivartante. They leave behind rasa for these vishayas. As soon as the person starts eating, the indriyas become strong and then the person will have all the ragas flood into the antakkarana. And vishaya will also be there. They will come back and drag the indriyas. What will happen? What will happen if a person were not to starve versus one where to starve has been shown, then how will this rasa go away? Rasopi asya param drishtva nivartate. Param, paramatmanam drishtva. Atmanam paramatvena drishtva. Rasa api asya jnaninaha nivartate vidushaha. Iti uktam. When will this completely go away? Rasa varjam. Vishayas have gone away, so they'll come back because taste is still there. Vasanas are there. When will these rasa rupa vasanas go away? They'll go away when there is paramatma jnana complete. Aikya jnana. So here, explanation is given. Niraharasi means bahya vishaya tyaginaha. One who gives away the indulgence by controlling in by force. That is the idea. Jignyaso visheshu. Stula Ragha Nivartati. Literally it means one who is starving. So starving need not be in food itself. You starve yourself as to I'll not indulge in any indriyas by forcing yourself. So like Gandhari, you tie your eyes. And so on. Parantu Rasa Shabda Vachyaha Vasana Rupaya Sukshma Raga Sa Api Parabrahma Aparoksha Jnana Nivartati Charthaha. The aparoksha jnana of Paramatma alone takes away sukshma raga, which is vasana rupa. That is said by rasa shabda. So mahavakyartha jnanam in the mula. Lakshana nirupanam. What is the lakshana definition? Now you need definition of implied meaning. There is a direct meaning of any sentence. There is an implied meaning of the sentence based on the direct meaning of the words and implied meaning of the words. Now this Mahavakya Artha Jnana, what is the meaning of the Mahavakya? Meaning the entire sentence Tattvamasi, what does it mean really? If you analyze it, is it the direct meaning or is it the implied meaning? So Lakshana is the implied meaning there. So to describe the Lakshana, first you have to know what Lakshana itself is. To say that Mahavakya Artha Jnana is not possible through literal meaning, as it is, you have to use some Lakshana. Now to use some Lakshana, which Lakshana to use, before you land on which Lakshana, what is the Lakshana of Lakshana? What does Lakshana mean? So you have to define Lakshana first. As to what is Lakshana, you have to analyze and explain what is Lakshana before you see which Lakshana will fit in and why. Why do you need Lakshana and which Lakshana to understand Mahavakya? Artha. Trivida Lakshana Nidadesha. These three types of Lakshanas we know, but now these are technical. Purvasmin Avarte Bhagatyaga Lakshana. So in 327th Avarta, we had seen Bhagatyaga Lakshana. Bhagatyaga Lakshana is Javadaja Lakshana. You hold on to what is common across the padas and draw what is not common, what is contradictory across the padas. That is Bhagatyagana, Bhagatyaga Lakshana or Jahadajal Lakshana. Bhagatyaga Lakshana Prapanchita, it has been elaborated. Tatra Hetu Varnana Varnanaya Idanim Lakshana Bheda Kathyate. Hetu Varnanaya. Why is Bhagatyaga Lakshana used there? Why not the other lakshanas or why not the direct meaning? Because Dvaitis are going to come up with these questions also. Purva Mimamsaka will say that it is Arthavada because such an equation is not possible. So what jnana are you getting from that Mahavakya? Why do you call it as Mahavakya even? What is the Mahatta in that Vakya? All these questions are going to come up. So you have to explain why you are using Lakshana, because the direct meaning does not make sense. Literally, it will not make sense. So people will drop that and call it Arthavada, but you have to use Lakshana. Otherwise, in Laukika, you don't have Arthavada in every case where there is contradiction. So Gangayam Gosha Shweto Dhavati Ityadi Vat. So Pandita hi Jahati Lakshana, Ajahati Lakshana, Bhagatyaga Rupa or Jahad Ajahati Lakshana Iti Trividham Lakshana Mahuhu. They say there are these three Lakshana, they are just names which we know. Tatra Adyadvayam. Adyadvayam is Jahati and Ajahati Lakshana. Mahavakyartha Jnane na Upayujyate. They are not useful in Mahavakya Artha Jnana. Mahavakyam hi Bhagatyaga Lakshanaya Bodhuhu Nijaswarupa Bhutam Brahma Bodhayati. So it reveals that Brahma as one's own Swarupa of the Bodha, of a Pramata, of an inquirer. Once one hears this Mahavakya Tattvamasi, then once Bhagatyaga Lakshana is used, then the knower who hears this, to him there is this Nijaswarupa Bhuta Brahma revealed. Meaning Brahma is revealed as one's own Swarupa through Bhagatyaga Lakshana. This is how the Shabda works, Shravana works. When Mahavakya is taught that time, when the Guru tells Tattvamasi, then the hearer, to the hearer, Bodha, Nijaswarupa Bhutam Brahma Mahavakyam Bodhayati. Mahavakya reveals it. That is what it is, Shabdika Jnana. Shabda Janya Jnana, Shabda Pramana Janya Jnana. That is what Shabdika has a different connotation. So let's not, I shouldn't be using that. Mahavakya Janya Shravana Janya Jnana is when the Mahavakya reveals the hearer your own Swarupa as Brahma on hearing the Mahavakya by Bhagatyaga Lakshana. So this is the Siddhanta. Now Lakshanayaha Samanya Swarupam Nivedaniyam Iti Shishya Prashnaha. Now the Shishya, when he hears this, as to there are these three types of Lakshanas, he wants to know what is Lakshana first. Shishya Pruchyati Swamin Samanya Jnana Antaram Hi Vishesha Jijyasa Bhavati. You cannot have, you know, desire for particular knowledge unless the general knowledge is there. So there should be general idea of what Lakshana is, then you can tell me it is Jahati Lakshana, Ajahati Lakshana or Jahad Ajahati Lakshana. So this Jahal Ajahal Lakshana that you talk about or Bhagatyaga Lakshana is applicable in the case of Mahavakya. Please tell me what is Lakshana first. Yatha Brahmanoyam iti Samanyata Jnate Tarantaram Sarasvatoyam Dravidoyam iti Vishesha Jnana Mudeti. Tatha Lakshanayaha Samanya Swarupa Jnana Anantaram Meva Jatyadi Vishesha Swarupa Jnana Kamsha Bhavet. If you know a person is a Brahmana first, then whether he is a Saraswata Brahmana or Dravida Brahmana, whether he is a North Indian Brahmana or a South Indian Brahmana, in general parlance, this is how we talk about. Saraswata is wherever Saraswati Nadi was, or those who have migrated from the Saraswati Nadi or to, you know, towards the east or eastern coast or western coast. So you have Saraswatas and Dravidas. This categorization is broad. That can also be made only when you know that he is a Brahmana. First you tell me he is a Brahmana, then you tell me he is a Saraswata or a Dravida. Iti Vishesha Jnana Mudeti, only when Samanya Jnana is known. Similarly, Lakshanaya Samanya Swarupa Jnana Antarameva Jhatyadi Vishesha Swarupa Jnana Kamsha Bhavet. Now, unless you tell me what is Lakshana, what desire will I have or how will I understand what is this Jhad Ajal Lakshana? thereby lakshanayah samanya jnanam vina jhatyadi vishesha jnanam na sambhavet. I won't understand what this jhatyadi, so I mean generally it is said, but then from Shishya's perspective he is saying that I won't understand if you tell me what is this jhati ajhati ityadi. Directly you have said that Mahavakya Jnana is through Bhagatyaga Lakshana. First tell me what is generally the meaning of Lakshana itself. What is the implied knowledge there? How does it work? I don't know how it works. I don't even know how Jnana takes place. You tell me what is Jnana in the most general case first. Then you tell me how this works so that I understand all the details. Tasma Lakshanayaha Samanya Surupam Pradarshetva Tato Jhatyadi Vishesha Surupam Tattal Lakshanadi Varnana Purvakam Bodhayantu Bhavanta Iti. So he says, may the Guru reveal this Lakshana by first dealing with this Samanya Lakshana. Then you talk about Jhatyadi, other Lakshanas. Please let the Guru discuss this. So Guru Uttaram Shakti Lakshanakhya Vritti Dvaya Nirdeshaha. This is the technicality. So Puro Vimamsa, Jnana is expected, or the Mula and Tippana discusses this in sufficient detail as to how this Jnana really takes place in any case. And then what is the Lakshana there? Guru Uttaram Shakti Lakshanakhya Vritti Dvaya Nirdeshaha. The teaching of this, these two vrittis, which is Shakti Vritti and Lakshana Vritti. Akhya is name. So either it is called a Shakti Vritti, Shakti Akhya Vritti, meaning that Vritti called as Shakti, or Lakshana Akhya Vritti, meaning that Vritti called as Lakshana. These are the two vrittis taught here. He Somya Eka Aikagrena Shrunu Mama Vakyam Lakshanam Tad Bhedanscha Janiyaha. So he says, listen attentively because it is a little technical. So now, although you have understanding of the Vedanta, now if you go into deep analysis of the Vakya itself, there you need technicality. Padasya Arthena Saha Ya Sambandha Tasya Vritti Iti Sanya. These two Vrittis are going to be discussed. What is the Vritti itself? There are many reasons why this word Vritti is used. You know, many places, synonyms to Vritti, many places where Vritti Sanya is used. Vritti is a sanya for what? Here, padasya arthena saha yaha sambandha. Pada and padartha have a sambandha. Purva Mimamsaka says that pada and padartha have a nitya sambandha. So, word and meaning have a nitya sambandha. In the case of Purva Mimamsaka, we are only looking at what is vritti. When vritti is being talked about here, that vritti means this means sambandha, the connection between pada and padartha. How it is a different matter, but this is the connection. Now this vritti is discussed here in the tippana. Tippana is more technical. Vatsasya gava saha sambandha asti. Now the vatsa ka has sambandha with her mother, its mother. The calf has sambandha with the mother cow, and it can identify the cow. In a herd of cows, if the calf goes here and there, the calf would run back and find its own mother. And it makes you wonder, you know, many cows, if they are of the same shade, we may not be easily able to identify the difference between them. Perhaps they also think that, you know, they see all the human beings same. They identify, after a while they identify as well. So the calf, however, identifies its own mother. Why? Because there is a sambandha. There is a matru putra or apatya sambandha. Matru apatya sambandha is there. So similarly, pada and padartha have sambandha, which is called as vritti here. So that is the discussion here. Vatsasya gavasa sambandho asti, tena sambandhina sa vatsa. Bauhinam gavam madhye vartamanam swamataram vivichya nyatva tan nikatam upasarpati. So the calf goes to its own mother, not somebody else. Sambandham vina pravruttir na bhavet. This pravritti is not possible. The calf going towards the mother cow is not possible unless the sambandha is there, which is what? Parent and child sambandha. तया प्रवृत्या वत्सस्य गोश्च जन्य जनक भाव रूप संबंधो अवगम्यते. सो व्हाट इज द कनेक्शन संबंध. सो यू हैव टू डिफाइन द संबंध. व्हाट इज द संबंध इन अनुबंध चतुष्टय. आल्सो वी डिस्कस संबंध. So there is a what kind of sambandha is there between the grantha and the prayojana in the anubandha chatushtaya. Similarly, there is a sambandha inquired into pada and padartha as well as here vatsa and gau. So janya janaka bhava rupa sambandha, the parent and child relation is there among them. Tadrusha janya janaka bhava rupa sambandhasya jnanam prati hetu bhuta vatsa pravruttirapi sambandha iti abhidiyate. Now they have the parent-child relation. The same word relation, the sambandha, is used for the tadrusha janya janaka bhava rupa sambandha, which is said as the parent-child relation in the case of the calf and the mother cow. Jnanam prati hetu bhuta vatsa pravruttirapi. This vatsa pravrutti, vritti word is there sitting there. This is very important. Prakarsha vritti pravritti. Just to understand the technicality there, vyakarana wise, this can be one meaning of that pravritti. Prakarsha vritti. The calf going towards the cow. That pravritti is also called as sambandha. So vritti which goes out is also called as sambandha. That's how we land on padasya arthena sahaya sambandha tasya vritti. Pravritti, if you add pra, this will be pravritti, it is sanya. Taking the example of the calf going towards the cow. Now, calf going towards the cow is a physical activity. That physical activity is also called as sambandha because there is janya janaka bhava sambandha which has drawn the vatsa towards the mata gau. So, very interesting. Now, in the case of Vedanta, the Vedantin says that there is a vritti of the, what is that jnana? That vritti which goes out, vritti formation is called as jnana, which is what sambandha really. Between the, this indriya which goes out, antakkarana which goes out through the indriyas, indriya drags the antakkarana, indriya dragging the antakkarana and falling on the ghatapatadi vishaya pada padartha really. So there is a sambandha and there is jnana idam, whatever you look at. Or in the case of this ghata, ayam ghataha. So ayam ghataha iti jnanam, that ayam ghataha iti jnana, that jnana is vritti rupa jnana. What is that vritti? Sambandha. This is what the tippanakara's mind seems to be in. So तादृश जन्य जनक भाव रूप संबंधस्य ज्ञानं प्रति हेतुभूता वत्स प्रवृत्तिः. ज्ञानं प्रति हेतुभूता, दैट वृत्ति प्रवृत्ति विच लीड्स टू सो ज्ञान. जन्य जनक भाव रूप संबंध ज्ञान बाय लुकिंग एट दिस प्रवृत्ति ऑफ दी वत्स गोइंग टुवर्ड्स दैट मदर काउ. यू नो दैट दी काफ इज दी, it's a calf of that mother cow. That is a jnana. I look at that, I infer, I have this jnana. So this jnana which has taken place, what is the hetu for that jnana? Janya janaka bhava rupa sambandha jnana between the calf and the cow. The vatsa pravrutti. That the calf went towards that cow. That becomes the hetu for my jnana that there is janya janaka bhava rupa sambandha. So, thereby this pravritti hetu bhuta vatsa pravritti api sambandha iti abhidhiyate. Evam eva shabdaram swaswarthe pravritti api na tayo shabdarthayo kanchana sambandham vina bhavet. So there is this double negation, seems to be a typo. It should be either this na or this na. So pravritti api na bhavet. Had there been no sambandha between shabda and shabda padartha, pada and padartha, if there had been no sambandha between pada and padartha, then this pravritti rapi, pada having pravritti towards the padartha won't be possible had there not been sambandha between them. Thereby, tathach shabdasya so vachyarthena sa vachyavachaka bhavarupa sambandha. So, some sambandha has to be revealed because of this pravritti of the shabda towards the padartha, pada towards the padartha. Any padartha reveals its meaning. So, therefore, the pada and padartha have a sambandha. Shabda says so vachyartha. Shabda is pada, so vachyartha is padartha. So, word and its meaning, which is the object really out there in the world, whatever it is, whether it is a physical object or it's a subtle object, gross or a subtle object, there is some meaning to it. That word and its meaning, or pada and padartha, I'll not translate it, I'll keep it as pada and padartha, because padartha is a loaded word. It can mean meaning also, it can mean the object also. Therefore, I'll just say pada and padartha. What padartha jnana takes place when you hear the pada? That padartha jnana, which has taken place with the shabda pada, ghata shabda gives ghata pada, gives ghata padartha jnana. Thereby, there is some sambandha between ghata pada and ghata padartha. So, tathaj shabdasya so vachyarthena sa vachya vachaka bhava rupa sambandha. What is that sambandha? Vachya vachaka. The word reveals the word is the vachaka and padartha. So, pada is vachaka, padartha is vachya. There is this kind of a sambandha between the two. Lakshartena saha lakshya lakshaka bhava rupa sambandha cha avagamyete. Now, this laksharta, the implied meaning which is there, there is an implier, if we can say that, this lakshaka, which reveals that implied meaning, and there is a revealed implied meaning, lakshya lakshaka bhava rupa sambandha. So, there is a vachya vachaka bhava rupa sambandha, and there is a lakshya lakshaka bhava rupa sambandha. When we say the word, what is tat? In the context, tat is that sad brahma. In the context of Chandogya Upanishad, sad brahma is tat. Ishvaraha, saguna brahma. In various genders, it has been talked about. So, we will call it as saguna brahma ishvaraha. So, that ishvara, jagat karta ishvara, is the vachya of the vachaka shabda tat. Tat is the vachaka. And Ishvara is Vachya. Tvam is the Vachaka Pada. And Vachya is Jiva. In the case of the, in that context, it is Shveta Ketu. So the Jiva, who is a Shariri, who associates oneself with this particular family, particular parents, particular friends, particular gender. So with the body, mind, sense complex, that is the Vachyartha of the word tvam, you. So when you hear the word you are that, then the hearer you, who is that? Being a hearer, at least he is a hearer or she is a hearer. So that pramata, who resides in this body, mind, sense complex, limited unto these faculties, is the tvam pada vachyartha. Laksharatha of the Tatpada is the Shuddha Brahma, Satchidananda Brahma, whereas Laksharatha of the Tvampada is also Shuddha Brahma. The implied meaning is that. So when it is said that you are Ishvara, you are not the Jagatkarta. With this body and mind, body mind sense complex, I can hardly create anything, let alone the entire prapancha. So obviously direct meaning is not where the equation is working. So you have to use the implied meaning. Now this implied meaning of the Tatpada is Shuddha Chaitanya without the Maya Upadhi, without the Maya Shakti, and this Avidya Shakti delimiting a person into the Sharira with Avidya Karya. So Sharira Traya is limiting the Satchidananda Tattva as though that is the real meaning. Satchidananda Tattva is the real meaning of the Tvampada also. That's a Laksharatha. So these are the sambandhas, to vachya vachaka bhava rupa sambandha, lakshya lakshaka bhava rupa sambandha. Dvividho api ayam sambandha, smarya smaraka bhava rupa sambandha iti api abhidiyate. So these are also having technical names. नॉट ओनली वाच्य वाच्य का भाव रूप एंड लक्ष्य लक्ष्य का भाव दीज आर इंडिविजुअल पर्टिक्युलर दे के नॉट बी इंटरचेंज हाउएवर बोथ आर कॉल्ड अस स्मार्य स्मारक भाव रूप संबंध बिकॉज वन इज रिकलेक्टेड द अदर इज हेल्पिंग यू रिकलेक्ट सो वन ट्रिगर्स द मेमरी द वर्ड ट्रिगर्स द मेमरी एंड द रिकलेक्टेड इज द ट्रिगर्ड फ्रॉम द मेमरी therefore they are also called both are called as smarya smaraka bhava so if you have heard of the teaching you know vachya vachaka is also smarya smaraka it will you will recall that so they are also smarya smaraka sambandhas and lakshya lakshaka also if you have heard the teaching it is also through memory smarya smaraka bhava roopa sambandha will come to mind so they are both called as smarya smaraka bhava roopa sambandha also vachya roopa athva lakshya roopa artha padena smarana yogya bhavati with the word you can remember therefore tasmad artha smarya ityuchyate vachaka roopa athva lakshaka roopa shabda tasya artha smarana yogyo bhavati so it is that which helps the memory therefore both of these vachaka and lakshaka are shabdas are called as smaraka तस्मात् शब्दः स्मारक इति कीर्त्यते तस्मात् शब्दार्थयो परस्परं स्मारक स्मार्य भाव रूप संबंध अस्ति शब्द एनी शब्द एंड एनी अर्थ वेदर द अर्थ इज लक्ष्यार्थ और वाच्यार्थ बोथ हैव स्मार्य स्मारक रूप संबंध तादृश संबंधस्य ज्ञानं प्रति हेतुभूता शब्दस्य स्वार्थे या प्रवृत्तिः सापि शब्दस्य अर्थेन सह संबंध इति वर्ण्यते So that pravritti is also called as sambandha, just like in the example. Tadrusha pravritti roopa sambandha eva shabdasya vritti riti uchyate. We have seen pravritti, you drop the pra upasarga, you get vritti. This is what is called as vritti in the mula. What is that? Sambandha. Between pada and artha, whether it is pada and artha, which is shabda and artha, which is lakshaka and lakshya, और वाचक एंड वाच्य बोथ आर कॉल्ड एज संबंध एंड दो संबंध स्मार्य स्मारक संबंध आर कॉल्ड एज वृत्तिज तादृश वृत्ति रूप संबंध क्वचित शक्ति रूप क्वचित लक्षणारूपश्च भवति एंड दिस संबंध कैन बी इधर शक्ति रूप और लक्षणारूप व्हाट इज द शक्ति रूप नाउ एनीवे इन द context vritti is a loaded word is explained here we'll just quickly go through this idam atra prasangad avadhyam it is contextual so that the word vritti does not lead to any more confusion as to whenever vritti is being talked about jnana roopa vritti what is that vritti it is only one type of vritti which is discussed here not the other types of vrittis vedanta shastre vritti shabda antakaranasya atva avidyayah parinamasya sanya in the case of rajju sarpa It is avidya parinama. In the case of Rajju, Rajju jnana, where Rajju does really exist, there it is vritti means antakkarana vritti. So either antakkarana vritti or avidya vritti, transformation of antakkarana or modification of avidya, these two are meant contextually in Vedanta Shastra when the word vritti is used, not the others, because vartanam atva sthiti rapi vritti rityuchyate kvachit. जीवनमपि वृत्तिरित्यभिधीयते प्राणव्यवहारोपि वृत्तिरिति वर्ण्यते व्याकरणशास्त्रस्य कश्चन विभागोपि वृत्तिरित्याख्यायते ईश्वर्थेषु मध्ये शब्दस्य अर्थेन सम्बन्धरूपा वृत्तिरेव अस्मिन् शास्त्रे वृत्तिशब्दस्य अर्थत्वेन ग्रहीतुं योग्या न अन्योऽर्थः सो द अदर मीनिङ्ग्स् आर् सीन् एज़् वर्तनमस्तीति यु नो सम्बडि इस् इन् अ पर्टिक्युलर् स्टेट् दट् इस् काल्ड् एज़् वृत्ति जीवनम् You know, livelihood is also called as vritti. He gives on bhiksha vritti. So, bhikshuka vritti, these are all also meanings of vritti. Prana vyapara is also called as vritti. Prana vritti, apana vritti, you know, prana vritti, apana vritti, vyana, udana, all these are also called as vrittis. Vyakrana, we also know, you know, vyutpatti or vritti, vigra vakyas, all these are also words such as vritti there. Among these, what is the meaning? Only the अंतकरण और दी अविद्या वृत्ति इज व्हाट इज दी योग्य अर्थ इन दिस ग्रंथ साच वृत्ति ही इन मूल साच वृत्ति शक्ति लक्षण इति द्विविधा इट इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स इधर इट इज शक्ति वृत्ति शक्ति संबंध और लक्षणावृत्ति लक्षण संबंध तयो स्वरूपम सलक्षणम वर्ण्यमानम श्रुणु इति गुरुर अवदत सो गुरु सेज दैट आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट दिस You listen to it attentively. Salakshanam, with definition, I am going to talk about Shakti Lakshana, Shakti Swarupa and Lakshana Swarupa. These are Sambandhas, Vrittis, and in Tippana, there is a lot of discussion. We will go through this as, you know, as possible. And there is a discussion on what is this Vritti in the case of Siddhanta and what is the case of the other Darshanikas where they talk about Jnana. We'll continue in the next part. Sukan Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namurupe Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddheer Drukyattu Nirmala Param Sarva Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Param Maha Tadeva Anna Matto Nyati Minishchitamatihi. Namaste. Oh, we started at 6, right? I'm sorry, I went a lot ahead.